Anya Cooper, president of the Young Men's Buddhist Association, and Venerable Dharmaratna Thero and other Theros from the Buddhist Society of India, Mr. Ravi Bhattaraj, General Secretary and other members of the Young Men's Buddhist Association in New Delhi. Ladies and gentlemen, other guests and dear children, let me say that it gives me immense pleasure and honor to be here at the 2562nd Vesak celebration of Buddha Purnima, organized by the Young Men's Buddhist Association of New Delhi. I have learned that every year the High Commission of Sri Lanka is invited by the YMDA for this sacred event. And I just learned that the YMDA has been organizing this for the last, I think the President, Mr. Manjur, announced that for the last 35 years continuously this event has been organized for Vesak Purnima. And I congratulate you for that. As we know, Vesak is the most important day for Buddhists across the globe, as Vesak commemorates three great events in the life of Lord Buddha: his birth, his attainment of enlightenment, and his passing away from Nirvana. In Sri Lanka, Buddhists celebrate Vesak in two ways: Pralakti Puja and Ahimsa Puja. In the first puja is indulgence by the devotees in religious activities such as observing seal, the precepts, and meditation programs conducted by the Mahasangha, Buddha pujas and sutra chanting, dharma discussions which enlighten the mind and obtain blessings and thereby enrich one's spiritual life. On the other hand, Ahimsa Puja is offering of dana to the Mahasangha and well-wishers, food and drinks to the people as well. One could also see colorful lanterns in homes and workplaces and display of giant pandas erected in public places that depict the Jataka story. Those who go out to enjoy the celebrations are treated to a feast of food and drinks by well-wishers who organize dances, that is, distribution of free food. Lord Buddha visited Sri Lanka three times in the 3rd century BC. Arhat Mahinda, the son of great Indian Emperor Asoka, accompanied by four Theras, brought the noble gift of Buddhism to Sri Lanka during the period of King Devanampiyatissa. Later, Therani Sangamitra, the daughter of Emperor Asoka, brought the sacred Bodhisattva, a branch of the Sri Mahabodhi, to Sri Lanka, which could still be seen in the ancient capital of Anuradhapura in Sri Lanka. When we consider bilateral relations, Buddhism is one factor that binds our two countries together. Sri Lanka, which is a Buddhist country, always remembers the historic religious connections with India. Nearly 200,000 Buddhist pilgrims visit India annually to venerate at the Buddhist sites, mainly the Gaya, Sarnath, Kushinagar, and of course Lumbini, which is the birthplace of Buddha, which is now in Nepal. It is believed that the true relic of Lord Buddha is also a gift by Emperor Asoka. Historic records indicate that Prince Danta and Princess Hemamala from Kalinga Desh, present Orissa, brought the sacred truth to Sri Lanka. The noble thoughts of Buddha and Lord Buddha and his teachings have a special relevance to the modern world as well. In today's world of storm and strife, hatred and violence, the immortal message of Buddhism is special and meaningful to all mankind. It is relevant in the 21st century, as it was 2.5 millennia ago. The teachings of Buddha mainly focuses on understanding life, the need to spread loving kindness on living on human beings, and of course even the animals, the impermanence of life and the path to alleviate suffering in life. It is a philosophy that carries, among other things, the message of kindness, righteousness, compassion and perseverance. Buddhism establishes the centrality of mankind as the master of his own wisdom. The philosophy of Buddhism emphasizes the values of compassion, loving kindness, non-violence, and peaceful coexistence and harmony. This universal message is internationally recognized by the United Nations. We can proudly say that it was an initiative of Sri Lanka by our former Minister of Foreign Affairs, the late Lakshmana Nandagama, who took the proposal to the United Nations and the UN Resolution 54/18 in 1999 designated Vesak as an international recognized religious festival. Last year, Sri Lanka hosted the United Nations Day of Vesak in Sri Lanka, in May, in Colombo, and also in Kandy. We are indeed honored and privileged. We were indeed honored and privileged to host the Prime Minister of India, Honorable Narendra Modi, at the inauguration of the conference. Prime Minister Modi, at the inauguration, spoke of the deep Buddhist heritage that is shared between India and Sri Lanka. The Prime Minister further said, and I quote, "The friendship between India and Sri Lanka was etched in time by the great master. Buddhism imparts an even ever-present radiance to our relationship. As close neighbors, our relationship spreads across many layers. It draws its strength as much through our interconnected values of Buddhism as it does from the limitless possibilities of our shared future. Ours is a friendship that lives in the hearts of our people and in the fabric of our societies." Unquote. This year, the Mahashula University of Ayodhya, Thailand, will host the United Nations Day of Vesak celebrations from 25th to 27th May 2018. The theme of this conference is Buddhist contribution to human development. I'm indeed very happy to say that in Sri Lanka this year, we are commemorating and celebrating Vesak with India, honoring and granting us the privilege of receiving the sacred relics of Lord Buddha from Sanya. Millions of Buddhists in Sri Lanka will have the opportunity to venerate at the exposition of sacred relics, which actually was inaugurated yesterday by our President and Prime Minister. And I think millions of people who have already started coming to Colombo to venerate and with the relics. We have also got sacred relics from Tanzania, Pakistan, and artifacts from Nepal and Pakistan. Venerable Mahasangha, ladies and gentlemen, while thanking the YMBA for organizing this religious event, I wish the association every success as we continue to be a beacon and a leading organization in spreading eternal message of God. May the triple gem